Have your Bibles, amen. Go with me to Acts chapter 12. I'll read one verse in your hearing. That's verse number 5. Amen. Amen. If y'all would have went to bed last night instead of watching the Bibles. Oh, bless the Lord. With bed, amen. Well, mighty God we serve, amen. Oh, y'all look at all sad, amen. You'll get on next year, amen. Amen. And the Lord is all I can have, amen. 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 They missed their chance, amen. In the book of Acts, amen, chapter 12, and verse number 5, it reads as thus. Peter, therefore, was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him. Amen. One verse in your hearing, amen, the word of God is blessed. May the hearer thereof be blessed also. Amen. I want to talk, amen, from the subject. It's a good time for the church to pray. It's a good time for the church to pray. Amen. In a time the world is in disarray as it is, that's a good time for the church to pray. In a time the economy is as funny as it is, that's a good time for the church to pray. In a time our kids are as messed up as they are, that's a good time for the church to pray. Because when the church prays, something will happen. And when the church sure enough pray, God will move. God's power is demonstrated through the church. God is known through his saints. But it's sad that the saints have stopped praying. It's sad that we wait till things get as bad as they are before we want to begin to pray. But the Bible tells us plainly that we are to pray without ceasing. Jesus even said that men should always pray and not faint. Oh, when the church start praying, amen, alcoholics will put down the bottle, drug addicts will drop their drugs, and prostitutes will begin to get saved. And I've looked at this situation that we're living in, and I've come to tell you now is a good time for the church to pray. When folks can't find jobs and they're robbing from Peter trying to pay Paul, it's just a wonderful time now for the church to start praying. Because when you look at the text, you'll find that the church was under heavy persecution. Remember, Saul had persecuted the church and had been converted. Stephen had been stoned to death. The disciples had been scattered abroad throughout Jerusalem, amen. And the word of God is being persecuted on every hand. And here they are now, and the Gentile churches, Antioch, is on the heavy persecution. The Bible said there was about that time that Herod the king stretched forth his hand to vex certain of the church. Herod Agrippa the first, amen, the grandson of Herodias the great, amen, who was the sister of Herodias, who had John the Baptist beheaded, amen. Just an evil line of people. And I want you to know that evil people are still around. Evil people are still trying to do the children of God all the harm that they can. Evil people don't hear nothing about your shout or your praise. They just waiting for the opportunity to try to pull you down or try to tear you down. They're still around. Don't fool yourself and think that everybody is saved. There's still some folk who are about their father's business, which is the devil. I wish I had somebody. The brother of John. Y'all know who James was? James and John, they were the two boys who said, "Jesus, Master, when you come into your kingdom, grant that I may sit on the one side and my brother on the other side." He is James, amen. The brother of Jesus, the disciple of Jesus, who had been killed with the sword. And there are folks who want to kill your joy. There are folks who want to kill your faith. There are folks who want to kill your hope. That's why negative folks have come at you when it seems like you're just getting yourself together, just getting ready to walk out in faith. Negative folks have come up just to kill your faith. So what he did was he killed James, the brother of John. And when he saw that, it pleased the crowd. Is that right? When he saw that it pleased the crowd, he decided to take Peter also. And when he went to take Peter, it was during the days of unleavened bread. When he, being a Jew, had a permanent position in the land of Palestine, why would he be excited about blessing his folks? Because he was trying to hold on to his position, and it was under Roman Greco rule, and he figured, if I please the Romans, I'll hold on to what I got. You don't hold on to what you have. Soldiers on the outside, but the church was praying for Peter without ceasing. When folks start going through something in the church, instead of the preachers talking about them, they ought to be praying for them. A whole lot of time I don't call folk because I'm praying for them. You don't have to call folk to know what's going on. If you just you, they're just trying to get in your business. one for the other. Instead of getting on the phone, talking about folks, talking folk down. Wouldn't it be amazing if we would just come together and say, I know what you're going through. Between two soldiers had chains on his arm.